I attended rehab young. Of course, it was inevitable. Only 17, but there were plenty of others my age and even younger. Put there by worried parents or drug courts. I went there in an ambulance myself, all the way from Mountainside Hospital to Pennsylvania. Strapped down on a stretcher after fighting cops and paramedics. But that's another story. The important part is that after rehab was over, I was in what they call intensive outpatient, forced to go to AA and NA meetings on a daily basis. I soon discovered the 12-step meetings open to the public in Overbrook Asylum. I had already been infiltrating the hospital grounds for years, but can now go inside legally and meet the patients who are sometimes allowed to attend. Since that time, I have known many alcoholics and addicts who have spent time in Overbrook. Also Grace. I became close friends with a few of these misfits and found firsthand how detrimental mental illness can be. One time, a guy who used to drive me to meetings, well, actually I shouldn't tell that story either. I had to smash his face a little. I'll just leave it at that. Yes. Funny how smoking weed and eating acid can really freak out straight parents and get your ass sent to rehab. But the best part was, I was given a key to the Mica ward, attached to the back male hill, clusters of small day rooms, hallways, and isolation cells, uninhabited on the nights of our meeting, which was Friday at 11 p.m. to 12:30 a.m. Young people's late night N.A. The Mica ward. Now demolished. I can still smell the nighttime day room and taste the urn coffee in my dreams. 2 years I carried the Mica key in my pocket, devoting myself to collecting candles to illuminate the circle of young addicts huddled together in the mentally ill, chemically addicted ward, usually inaccessible, but ours every Friday night. And after the meeting, we would hang out late on the ward, and then go to the Pilgrim or Nevada Diner for better coffee and more talk. When the meeting first moved from its previous location in the Verona Methodist Church basement due to noise complaints, we started meeting in the Mica ward, using the room with a giant parrot painting that said, "Don't be a parrot." It was a dark and spooky section of the hospital, even then, before it was abandoned, especially at night. As the meeting grew and became well attended, we moved the circle to the Mica day room, where the darkness ate up the candlelight, no matter how many dozens of wicks I would set ablaze. We were mostly a rowdy bunch of kids, primarily young addicts, fresh out of rehab, and it didn't take long for our meeting to stray from 12-step doctrines into something else. Our circle became more like a black mass or a seance than a typical meeting. And the few hardline recovery people that visited our midnight insane asylum gatherings often left offended because we had gone rogue and were incorporating other unsanctioned meditation, like saying prayers backwards until the clues of meaning, or the various sessions of truth or dare that would sometimes arise in place of steps and traditions. Just a little too autonomous for comfort, which led to the downfall of meaning eventually. It took about 2 years, and they eventually did shut us down, and we weren't allowed in Lake Memorial. I think I still have the key somewhere, although the building is now gone, along with most of the rest of the insane asylum of my adolescence. Almost immediately after Overbrook was officially abandoned in the spring of 2007, I found myself back on the Michael Ward, this time not needing or seeking permission. Trespassing illegally through memories of my late teen years, walking down blackened corridors with a smile on my face, and gaining access to the back mail hill, which was locked during our meeting era, but was now an open passage to the labyrinth of wards. Standing in the Micah Day room, now overflowing with hospital mattresses and medical waste piled here for storage, I can still see our group, many of which have now died or moved on. And I can still feel them, my old friends, sitting around a pyre of candles, pouring their hearts to the group, trying to make sense of an insane world from the depths of asylum. Although perfectly free to leave, unlike the patients behind locked doors, stuck in the system, confined to their cells, but here for the same reason as us. I also went and took pictures of the parrot with this seemingly eternal message, "Don't be a parrot." And my adult self felt happy here, where my young self learned so much, not lamenting the closing of Overbrook, just happy to be here again, this time on my own terms. And guess what? Now I don't need the key, I can no longer find. The locks have been cut off the doors for liability reasons. There are no locked cells in Overbrook anymore, for fear some trespasser might get shut in and never be found. I was happy to see the hospital close, so I could infiltrate further than ever before, and see long-awaited rooms like the sterilization lab, x-ray studio, and morgue of the reception building. But when I stood in the woods and watched the machines picking the mentally ill, chemically addicted ward to pieces, I felt a pang in my chest. And then when the building was gone and they tore down the enchanted woods, that last strip of spooky haunted forest, to build a community center where once played out scenes of childhood magic and contemplative walks in adulthood. And yes, I was sad, but also grateful to have intimately known Overbrook Asylum in all seasons for my whole life, not as a helpless patient or a paid employee, but as an infiltrator, a curious outsider who wanted a glimpse and kept placing himself unseen within the walls of the old asylum. Trespasser, trustee, and then trespasser again. Now a demolition documenter, as the last of the wards fall to the teeth of the caterpillars of Kumatsu. But even though the Mica ward is gone, I often return there in my thoughts to sit around teenage pyres of candles once more and remember gifts received in childhood. Although hard learned at the time, now invaluable and essential to the man I have become.